Hi, everybody. David Allen back with Russell Bishop. Oh, my God. You know, this is about, you know, Russell coming to the GTD Summit. Russell, gee, we're just such new friends, right? We've only been hanging out together for 41 years. Excuse me. When I was in a seminar of Russell's and I said, I want to work with you because you're doing such great work in terms of human consciousness and potential and all that good, great stuff back in 1978. So, delighted to have you, of course, Russell. You and I have crossed paths in and out and convergent and divergent paths, parallel, you know, simultaneous, you know, for all these years. So tell everybody who may not know who Russell is, give me as short a paragraph as you can about who Russell is, what you're doing, what you're about.
Well, over the years, the long answer has gotten shorter. And I'd say my career has been around awakening. And there's a lot of people out there yelling, wake up. But as our shared spiritual teacher would have said, hey, when the one-year-old baby is sleeping, do you wake him up so he'll grow faster? No. Awakening is a natural state that the only thing that awakens is something that was asleep, but the only thing that's asleep was previously awake. So the work I've been engaged in is helping people discover something that's always been present, but perhaps they've been asleep too. So that's yes. One way of thinking about the work.
And I would say, given all of my experience with you closely, Russell, as you know, over these years, is indeed, you know, and you are a master at being able to frame that, articulate that, and poke people in the right places that get them to be more in part of that game. So thank you. You know, if I haven't said that recently. And so what's curious about the summit that you're coming to, and what sort of intrigues you or interests you about the fact that you're going to play with us?
Well, as our mutual admiration society continues unabated here, obviously supporting the work that you're bringing to the world is a whole lot more than the mundane might suggest of getting things done. It's really about making differences worth making. And helping people streamline and hold focus so that can take place. So that's something we've shared forever. I love the notion of there are no problems, only projects. In the book that you helped me endorse, the chapter in there was how you frame the problem is the problem. And our mutual friend, Erwin Carasso, with many successful businesses under his belt, I interviewed him and I said, Erwin, how did you address all the problems that must have shown up over these 30, 40 years? He says, I never had a problem. I kind of went, what do you mean? He says, well, if I had a problem, then I had a problem mindset, and all I would find was more problems trying to solve problems. But if I called a problem a puzzle, well, puzzles are fun to solve. And if you think of a jigsaw, there's a picture on the box. So all you really need to do is get a clear picture of what the outcome looks like and then find the pieces and fit them together. That's a wonderful insight.
Yay. No kidding. And, you know, I've invited you to do a keynote, and you're also going to hang out with me, with Dean Acheson, and, you know, have a conversation about the origins of GTD and its DNA, of which you were a key mentor and a player, you know, in that whole game. So all that's going to be fun. But given the sort of, what do you want people to take away from, you know, what you're going to tell them? Other than what you just said, I mean, that was pretty profound in and of itself. Anything different or more compact than that you would frame?
Well, yes, I think there's a mutual friend of ours, Frances Hesselbein. Several years ago, I stopped by her Park Avenue office in New York City. Hadn't seen her in several years. And rather than say, oh, Russell, good to see you. How are you? What have you been up to? She looked at me in the eye and she simply said, Russell, what are you seeing that's not yet visible? And I was like, oh, what an incredible question. And it caused a whole lot of dominoes to click in my life, going back to a spiritual teacher who said, Russell, you've been struggling to see with your physical eyes things you can only see with spiritual eyes. So with Francis's one simple question, it caused me to notice the difference between looking at something and looking to see what's being revealed to me. And I think that's a frame for the world. Something is being revealed to us if we only have the wit to see. But that means we may have to look with more than our mind. We may have to look even deeper. So something around that seems like
pretty profound. Well, thank you, Russell. We'll sign off here again. You and I could talk for about 64 years about our 41 years together, you know, continued on. So lovely to see you in June when you and your lady, you know, show up here. And everybody, hey, come on. Russell's going to hang out for the whole summit. So come and play. Thanks, Russell.
Thanks, David.